Hello guys, and welcome to another one of my little videos. Mandalorian season 2 is over, and I have some thoughts. Before I start, let me give you a spoiler warning. If you haven't seen the new season yet, you might want to stop the video right here. I'm not gonna go episode by episode here, but I'm just gonna point out some bits that I found interesting. Some good and some not so good. First of all, I haven't seen all of Clone Wars, so some of the characters from the Clone Wars appearing in this season were not that familiar to me, or at least I didn't have any emotional connection to them. So the episodes revolving heavily around Bo-Katan or Ahsoka Tano were probably less interesting to me than they would be to someone who's a fan of the Clone Wars. They were still interesting episodes with lots of entertaining action, though. Moff Gideon wasn't a bad antagonist, but I did kind of expect him to offer our heroes some fried chicken at any moment. Jokes aside, he was a bit mustache twirly, and we didn't really get to know much about his motivations. So he was a bit surface level evil. Generally, my biggest gripe with the show was that the main characters lacked depth. The emotional core of the show is really built around Mando's relationship to Baby Yoda, or as we now know, Grogu. But he doesn't really have any character, other than being cute and always hungry. So Mando's attachment to him is based mostly, at least as we see it, on Grogu being cute. Some of the side characters had more depth than the main duo, even though they were only in one episode. And I actually enjoyed those episodes the most. I'm talking mainly about Bill Burr's character. The season 2 episode he appeared in was probably my favorite of the show so far, as it had something to say, while also having some of the best action. I also liked the Marshall guy, who had Boba Fett's armor, and that entire episode felt like a mini-movie and was probably my second favorite this season. Speaking of Boba Fett, when the Marshal first appeared, I was actually really relieved that he turned out not to be Boba Fett. Boba Fett was never a very interesting character in the original trilogy. He was actually more of a cool prop than anything else. And his most interesting trait was that he was mysterious. So the attempt to bring him back and give him a backstory in the prequels never really resonated with me. Not to mention that it spurred one of the more terrible changes to the original trilogy when Jeremy Bullock's voice, God rest his soul, was replaced by Temuera Morrison's. So to me, the return of Fat Fat wasn't particularly cool or welcome. Don't get me wrong, it didn't spoil the fun for me, and it was kind of cool to see Slave One in action. It just didn't really get me excited. In general, I would prefer The Mandalorian to stay the self-contained story which was established in Season 1. But to be fair, Boba Fett was the only one of the cameos of characters we know from somewhere else that felt quite fanservice-y and forced. They really did have to bend over backwards to shoehorn him in. Most of the other cameos made sense in the storyline. Mando was looking for other Mandalorians, so it does make sense that he would find Bo-Katan and her cohorts. And then he's looking for Jedi, so it does make sense that he would find some of the characters that we know to be some of the last surviving Jedi. Namely Ahsoka, and of course, the biggest cameo of them all, Luke Skywalker. Now, when Luke first appeared and they kept slowly revealing hints that it's actually him, I did get quite excited, but at the same time I was kind of dreading the moment they would show his face. And as it turns out, rightly so. The CGI on Luke was distractingly awful. I had the same problem with Tarkin in Rogue One. I was so distracted by the creepiness of it that it completely took my attention away from the dialogue and the story. As a visual effects artist, I totally understand how difficult it is to pull something like this off, especially on a tight budget. But that's why I would much prefer if they just recast a different actor. I mean, they did it with Solo, and sure, you could argue that It's supposed to be young Han Solo, but actually he's supposed to be almost the same age as Harrison Ford is in the original Star Wars. But if the character absolutely must look like young Mark Hamill, why not hire one of the YouTube deepfake guys? I mean, they already proved they can do a great job with Tarkin and Solo. And sure enough, it only took a couple of days for a deepfake of Luke from Mando to appear on YouTube, and it actually does look a bit better than the original. Now imagine what one of these guys could do if given the budget and time that ILM had for this scene. Jon Favreau said in some interview that the reason it doesn't look quite as good as you might expect is that they tried to keep it as secret as possible. But all you'd really need would be one YouTuber with a signed non-disclosure agreement. So I mean, how much more secret can you get? But other than this one thing, the show's visual effects are absolutely fantastic. And watching some of the visual effects heavy sequences, I was constantly in awe at how good it all looks. I'm not sure what the VFX budget of the show is, but I'm sure it's quite a bit lower than a feature film. So to achieve this level of realism is no mean feat. Overall, the show is filmed beautifully. It manages to visually feel like the old Star Wars, but quite modern at the same time. The story is simple but effective, and it really carries the spirit of the old Saturday morning serials which inspired George Lucas to make his space epic that we all love. The Mandalorian is not without its problems, but overall I still think this is probably the best live-action Star Wars since Return of the Jedi. Well, that's it for today. If you want to support this channel, you can become a patron or donate directly to PayPal. Links in the description below. Thank you guys very much for your support. Thanks for watching, and may the Schwartz be with you.